Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed, and today, I got Nuke Dukem with me. And she's going to be my Sherpa, my senpai, through this VR landscape. And today, we're going to be playing Medal of Honor. But before we dig into this beefy, beefy masterpiece, Jessamyn is going to walk us through what we're going to be playing on here today.
Okay, so check this out, all right? I got the box still. First of all, is this not a really nice looking box? See how smooth it looks? Look at that. Look at the games. We got all kinds of good stuff here, right? Quest 2, the Oculus Quest 2, the upgrade to the original Quest, which was, for the record, an amazing headset. The first all-in-one headset. You don't need sensors, you don't need a cable, you don't need any of that. It was the original. But they have gone and outdone themselves with the Quest 2, all right? It's just, it's amazing. Let me just shut up, look at it, all right? First of all, this headset. I wish I had my Quest 1 to compare and show. Here. Austin's got me, all right? The Quest 2, while,
sorry,
you
this
know.
Is, just so you guys know, this is the Quest 1.
That's the Quest 1. And while it is amazing, this is the new, improved, and upgraded version of such a fine headset. Now, the first thing that I noticed when I got the Quest 2 was that it's lighter, okay? Mm-hmm. Which is a big deal. That's a huge deal. When you have something on your head that you want to keep there, you'd want it to be comfortable. And that, for me, was immediately, I'm like, I'm sold. This was already worth it because it's so much more comfortable and lighter than the first one. And all you need, all that comes in this box, because it's all you need, is your headset, your controllers, which, by the way, they look like basically the same. I've seen people being like, there's no difference in the controllers by looking at them. But when you touch them and you hold them and you feel the difference, there is like something, I don't know what they did exactly. It reminded me more of like the OG Rift controllers, which I really liked. And your charging cable. That's it. That's literally it. That's it. So you get it and it's like, oh, like I'm, you know, like that's it. No sensors, no computer, no massively powerful computer needed to set this up. No, I don't think so. All right. Also, check this out. Because people ask this all the time, all right? Because I play a lot of VR. People watch me and they say, I wear glasses. Can I still play in VR? Yes, yes you can. And there's a very simple attachment that comes in your Quest to pop into the headset, which by the way, it's just so easy, like how this stuff like pops out and you make adjustments, pop it back in, set it. Like there's not like, I don't need tools. I don't need anything to do this. I just pop it out, I put it in and I snap it back in place.
Get your Phillips head screwdriver.
No, yeah, none of that is necessary. It's just so easy, all right? Now, because I'm me, all right? I had to get the upgraded, of course, Oculus Elite head strap, which was a super easy upgrade. Yet again, you pop off the old one, I pop on the new, and now I have this adjustable Elite head strap.
What?
Yeah, yeah.
Where did you get that?
From Oculus, sir. From Oculus.
That looks awesome. So I'm rocking what comes in the box so you guys can see it. This strap, this is insanely comfortable. When you were talking about the Elite strap, I was like, oh, that's what I have, clearly. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. This is incredibly comfortable. I also want that.
Yes, and I think that there's like a time and place for both. I think some people may find one more comfortable. If you got a lot of hair or you know whatever, it might be more comfortable to have the flexible strap. Like, but there's options. And I'm like I said, because I'm me, I wanted the Elite strap, and I was not disappointed with my choice. and it worked out great. So that's what mine looks like. And then on top of that, I got the cool all-in-one Oculus travel case. Everything I need fits in here. Literally everything. Controllers, cords, headset, you name it.
Jessamyn acquired these things way before we were gonna do this video.
Yes.
Way before.
I've been a really big fan and supporter of Oculus basically since I got the original Rift and I was like, this changes everything for me. So like I knew I was okay investing in the setup further at this point with the Quest 2 because I knew what I was getting into and I'm comfortable like with the products and how they like what I get, what I'm getting, you know? And so all of these things like make my setup. And by the way, the Elite strap obviously still fits inside nice and tight, like keeping it nice and tight in there. All right. So it's great. It just makes it easy. You can pop this in a backpack and then like you're good to go and you pop it out and you got VR wherever you want. Like it's amazing. It really is. Now let's talk about Medal of Honor. Okay. Because it is a beefy, a hefty.
It's a big one. It's a big one.
But it's worth it. You use the Oculus Link cable, you plug it into your PC, and now you get this like unbelievable experience being plugged into your PC. Like that to me is also really nice. It's nice to have that option to play the PC VR games as well. But it is necessary for Medal of Honor, but I'll be honest, it's worth it. Like when you see the graphics and you see how smooth the game runs, it's like, yeah, no, this is like, this is nice.
It's like they were able to obviously put everything in a headset that you can travel with and just use whenever you want. But I do enjoy that they're able to create this link between the headset and the computer so that if you want to run like crazy high performance things on it, you can use the power of your computer to do that and you're not cut off from doing it just because you have this untetherable headset to play VR stuff. And so when we play Medal of Honor today, we're gonna be linked into our computer so we have that full like insane, crazy experience. And it's, like we said, it's a big one. So make sure you got the space, because it's a big one, and then you can play. But here you go. We're going to jump in now. I need to find out how to reload. It wasn't letting me. I feel like we should do that before we start this, but.
Yeah, is there a
Team Deathmatch. Team Deathmatch, let's go.
Let's go.
Oh, hey.
Hey, there you are.
Oh, hey. What up?
Sweet scarf.
Thank you. That's I can't nice see it. Scarf. I have a syringe.
Oh, wait. No, it's a collar. It's a collar. I see it.
I stabbed myself with a syringe.
You stabbed yourself.
Oh, what up, Jose?
What? I'm not ready.
Captain Jose is here. Oh, no, CPU, not Captain.
There's my gun.
Gun. Where's our guns? Eliminate them. I pulled it off my back.
Oh, reach.
I pulled it off my back.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, same.
You're done.
Okay, all right, I'm ready.
Okay.
I'm ready, wait.
Where are we going?
I'm following.
Let's go. Yo, how do we crouch? I heard shots. Shots fire.
I see somebody.
Oh, we just gotta actually crouch.
Ah!
I got one! Screw that guy.
You got
I'm
one!
I'm hurt. I need my syringe. Syringe!
It's on your
set!
No!
I threw it! Hit him. Oh, I got him! Oh my god, long range shot. Holy crap! I don't have any more bullets.
Ah, got one!
I don't have any clips.
What?
I don't have any clips to put in this gun.
You're out of ammo?
Yeah.
Oh. It's not on your belt anymore?
No, I got a grenade.
I have unlimited ammo.
I got a grenade, though.
Do it. Woo!
Oh, no! God! Myself! Oh, I put it back. I throw the grenade, dude! Throw the grenade! Do I have to pull it off?
Yep. And then pull the pin.
No, he kicked it!
Watch
it! Throw it hands! Give me that gun. Let's go. Huh? What are you at, though?
Oh my god, headshot! What?
Nice.
That was amazing.
Was that dynamite? No. Oh, hold on, I gotta do some papers. Paperwork. I can't click it, okay. Teresa.
There's no time for paperwork.
Back the way, Teresa. What happened to you? They got you?
Not yet. Oh my god, they didn't get me. I survived somehow.
Syringe!
Boom!
Not today, Joselito.
Got one. Theodore's down. Got one! Oh my god, I'm nasty with it.
Get out of here, nasty. Grandma!
Give me a new clip. They want to come through. We got gun bars. We got gun bars on them. Freestyle them with a banana clip. Peel them like a banana slip. One foot in the grave. Oh, one foot on. Oh!
Excuse me.
careful when you jump out the shower, because I don't want you to slip.
We're nasty at this. Clearly, we run team deathmatch.
Yes. That was really fun, actually.
The syringe action. Jessamyn, I'm right next to you. I'm with you. You ready? We got this.
Let's go.
Let's do it. Move him out. I'm gonna flank from the left side, okay?
Yep, yep. Oh god, coming. Here we go. Get out of here, Grandma. Ooh, Dan, first kill. I'll take that.
Oh, I see him. I'm gonna go over here.
Look at you with the superior positioning.
I had the high ground, but I'm gonna see if I can go underground. There's an underground. I'm underground.
Dang.
All right, I'm creeping.
Oh my god.
I'm creeping,
god.
Syringe in hand, ready to do what I can.
Oh my god, I see you going, it's so funny. Ooh, I got got.
You did? No.
But I threw the grenade, so hopefully. I'm ahead of you with three kills right now. Oh, there you go.
But I got. Oh, he's behind me. They were behind me. I'm running the battle.
Got
like
one,
crazy.
Got one. Oh my goodness. No.
Okay. Big throw. You can get anybody. Okay, that's fine. What's that spawn? Camp the spawn. We don't play fair.
Nope.
We don't play fair. Call us Miss Swan. What do you want? Bye, Dan.
Oh,
I got your back.
Oh my god, that was amazing. That was amazing.
I had you.
Yes. I was like, I'm dead. And
nah. Jessamyn, I got you. I gotta run in here. Oh god! Oh no, it's our friend. Syringe? I lost the headphones.
You have to do that when you do, because it's so intense.
It hurts.
Like, yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah, I feel it.
Dude,
I
love this. Where they at? No.
Oh my god.
Where they at?
I can legit peek through a crack in the door, man, and shoot through it.
I got this guy. Oh.
Look at that. Through the door.
Oh, God.
Oh,
got
you.
Nice.
Got you.
Because I didn't, when you reload this gun, you have to pull the deal on top to get it ready to shoot.
Yep.
And I forgot. But it cost me my life.
That's why we train, soldier!
Yeah. Oh, we got it.
Look at that! Look at that!
I got 22 kills?
That's right.
Holy crap!
That's right. Yep, that's right. Dude, these graphics are insane.
It's kind of wild.
What?
Stats. Wow. Okay, let's try. So I don't want to do team deathmatch.
Insane.
Let's do blast radius. Free-for-all control points will activate periodically around the map. Gain extra points by getting kills from inside an active control point. Match ends after 3 control points. About 7 to 9 minutes, it says. Is this team? This is not team.
Oh, that's... Oh!
You got me.
Did I just kill you?
You did. Dang it. Okay, yeah, give me better.
Yeah, time for first. That's right, baby. Let's go.
I hit nothing.
So slick. I love it.
Really is.
It's fun in a way that I wasn't really expecting it to be fun.
No!
The computer got me!
Let's come in here.
What is
and clean
this?
Some house!
What the hell is this?
Who are you? Get out of my circle! Get out of my circle!
Whoa!
No!
Wow, Jessamyn!
Who got me?
That's me!
Who got me?
That's me!
God.
Okay, gamer.
Oh, I'm coming. I'm coming for you.
Come through.
It's a mission of vengeance now.
Please.
Oh my god, I feel like I'm badass. I feel like such a badass right now.
Right.
Come on.
Are you in the circle getting points?
No, maybe. Am I? Do what if so?
Okay, okay. Good to know. Oh god, and I'm boxed. Dang it. Dang it.
Okay.
Ah, you're beating me! Yo, I'm on this, like, reload the gun now.
The reload feels so good.
It does. Having that extra step to have to, like, pull the whatever, I don't know, gun terms, to get the gun ready to shoot. You rack it, yeah.
You rack it.
Fiber, so we're a little closer. No, you're still up by 10.
Nah, not on my watch.
Come on. Ah! Come on, dude. Come on.
No!
Hey, you got me, didn't you, up top? Dang it.
Find the circle.
Yeah.
Woo! Get inside the circle.
50 points.
Okay. Let's go.
Gotta just hope we don't converge at the same time. Nope.
Dang it! Oh! Dang! What do you think you're doing here?
I'm trying to get something else. Crushing it. Dead ski.
Best
buzzer beater kill at the end.
That was fun.
That's great. Okay, here we go. Oh, what's Mad Bomber? Let's try Mad Bomber. Free for all. Every player has a timed explosive that can be placed on any surface. Gain extra points for killing enemies with your explosion and disarming enemy explosives.
Okay, what do we do? Where's my explosives?
Holy crap. Oh my god, the scope is so tight. Oh my god, this is cool. Holy crap. Where's these bombs?
Yep.
This bomb is on my person.
This is not a game?
You've tied for first place.
Oh god. I can't shoot him, he's too close. I don't have, oh, that's not good. I might have to switch. But I'm gonna get a kill. I'm gonna get a kill first with the with the sniper.
You won't do it.
I hear so much violence, but I see none. I don't know how to
shotgun.
I can't successfully rock with this thing. Oh, there we go. Okay, I have to, wow, that's difficult. That's hard, that's a hard thing to do. I got one with the shot, okay, I'm good. I don't have to do anything else this whole game. Got two. And, of course.
No!
Shoot them! Shoot it! Ow! I got her with a timed explosive! Let's go!
That's like the best way to get points in this one.
Yep. Is that my deal? Got one, another one with the sniper. No syringes left. Bomb's going down.
Someone is trying to take first place from you.
Oh, they are? Nah, son. No!
You've dropped down to number two, so
that
spot belongs to you.
Ah, it does belong to me. Oh, I see you. I got popped right before I could do my deal. That's fine. Peek a little bit. Dang, 29, 25. 25, 30. Dang it. I gotta take my
load up.
Dang!
Oh, no! I caught on the reload, man.
What? Oh my god, my bomb popped somebody. That's 5 points.
Oh my god, next point win. This is not, this is insane.
That's me! That's me! That's me right there!
No!
That's me! That's me! With the next point, with the scope, from the stairs, let's go! Scoping over the shoulder, bam! I'm facing the wrong direction! I'm facing the wrong direction, but now I'm not! That's me with the last point! Wow. This is incredible!
I cannot believe how invested I got. I know. In that. When it said last point, I was like, whoa! Yes! Like, this is crazy.
Dude, the sniper rifle is so cool, but so like weird.
This is really
to
fun.
Use.
This is.
Dude, now imagine that with us, your girls, my guys. It's 4-on-4 yes. Playing this. My God.
Oh my God. Yeah.
It's crazy, like coming out of VR world when you're in for so long. I didn't realize we were playing for an hour.
What? Really?
Yeah, we were like my recording, my Streamlabs said it had been on for an hour.
So that's like, I think a good argument for when the graphics are good and smooth and like it's that upgrade really makes a difference and makes it you able to play longer. Mm-hmm. Like really high quality games are just easier to play, I think, for longer periods of time. Like that's crazy.
Okay, so I know that you play a lot of VR stuff, Jessamyn. This is like, VR is like your forte. And so with that being said, you being my Sherpa, my senpai into this VR realm, because I do play, but I have the tendency to get like very, very queasy, mm-hmm. like very quickly, especially in VR. And so that's why I was like nervous about this, because it's like, oh, you know, it's like full walk around and you can move and stuff. And so like after I went through all the settings to change like my comfortability level or whatever, this is the first time I've ever played a VR game where I could actually like run around and comfortably move around and I didn't ever feel sick. And so like in your experience, like what's the difference between that and VR games that would normally make me sick?
I think so. This is just how I feel about it. And when I've played games, what made the difference? Because I was like that too at first. When I first started playing VR, there was like an adjustment period and I would, you know, you would play for like a little bit and then I would have to take a break so that, you know, you just have to adjust. And over time, it does get easier. But I think I've noticed is when the graphics are really good and the gameplay is really smooth, I think, I don't know, it's just a theory, but I think your brain has an easier time. It feels more real. I think when it's not, you know, it's less realistic. It's harder for your brain to adjust. But I also think the movements in the game are just natural. The turning, like you just feel like you're really doing it as opposed to using a controller or something. And so it just felt a lot more natural. All of the motions of reloading, all of the motions of just like scanning for people, the having to crouch to actually crouch, and then like peeking around cover feels, it just feels really good. That's all I can say. Like, and I think when you have a game like that, that's really high quality, it just makes it easier for people to play and not notice that, you know, they're in VR, especially if it's something you've had a problem with. But yeah, that was amazing.
Yeah. I highly recommend this. this is fantastic.
Seriously, like by far one of the most quality games I've played in VR. And I feel like I've at least tried a wide variety over lots of different headsets and just a wide variety of games that I've you know, dipped my toe into. Mm-hmm. I think that is easily the highest quality game. Graphics, gameplay,
definitely.
Smooth, like just the smoothness. I was looking at the water and I'm like, I can't even, like, this is team deathmatch, and I'm just like, I can't stop staring at the water.
You're looking at the river.
Yeah, like that's crazy. That's crazy that there's that much detail, and it just, I think it helps with the immersion, and it's amazing. Like I'm kind of just like, whoa, dude.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet. And so for me, like moving around, like in any way, shape or form in VR, like I said, always flips my stomach upside down. So like I was very, very surprised. I was nervous, but then like in that, you guys didn't see it in the video, but at the beginning of the game, you play like a little tutorial, and it's cool the way they do it. Like you're at the doctor's office and you've gotten like messed up in battle. And so now they're running you through like a physical, and that's how they go through like, oh, do you want to like have smooth turning movements, or do you want to have it like, you know, you click the button and you're just automatically there. So like you had smooth turning on, right?
Yeah. So I turned it up to like the intense setting where it doesn't, because there's some where you move, it will narrow the vision slightly, which helps for a lot of people. It's really good. And it's nice that it's that flexible that you can like adjust it like that. But yeah, I had it on the intense settings and the smooth turning, but it just like, normally when you press forward on a controller and you start moving in VR, you have this like, but like, I didn't get any of that. I didn't feel any of that. It just, I don't know why it feels so good. I think it's just because the graphics are so awesome. That's really my theory. I think it's just it's just good.
I think so. So one thing that I noticed, just even having to like dump the clip, grab it, what is it called?
Racking
it in order to like have bullets. Like, I think maybe since my mind was so focused on that and pulling grenades and stabbing myself with a syringe and stuff, like I didn't have time to think about the movement. Cause I feel like in other games I'm worried about like, well, I gotta walk over here, and I'm only focused on the fact that my brain and my body are like doing this.
Mm-hmm.
As where with this, like it's happening for like a second, but then as soon as I get shot, I go, oh, syringe, okay, bullet, boom, racket, here we go. So like, I don't have time to think about like that mind body dissociation deal.
The grenades too, like the aim and just the feel, I was like, oh, it felt like the grenades felt weighty to me, which is like sounds silly to say, but I don't know, it tricked my brain. I don't know what else to say. Yeah. Like it felt like I'm holding it, so I'm like, it's just so satisfying. Oh my god.
And the fact that like, so obviously like playing by yourself, like if we played that by ourselves, it's like, okay, cool, this is a fun like solo experience. But the fact that like it feels like we're in the same room. That's what I'm trying to say. Like, it feels like we're in the same room playing with each other, since I can't see that you're not next to me, but I hear you in my ear just like you're next to me with the whole VR headset, and we're playing team deathmatch. Like, it's,
the directional hearing is some of the best that I've ever, like, just being able to hear. And then as I turn and look, I can just hear the sound shift like it should, which is another thing that I think just helps your brain be like, oh, like it just doesn't, there's not this disconnect. They did so good with all of that, and like seeing the, like you said, seeing you, and like I could literally spot you from across the map and know that it's you. I don't even have to see your name. It's just like a crazy thing to know, like, oh, I can actually like see you over there. And I will say this, there's not lots of multiplayer games like that. the more that you experience different things in VR, it helps you just sort of acclimate to, it's like learning a new thing. It's learning a new way to game. It really is. It's so different. And I think what's so neat about like VR in general is how they're finding new ways to make the games fun. Just like reloading being fun. Like you just like normally if you're holding a controller, it's like you just
click it.
Yeah. There's not this like cool action of like racking the gun and just like that.
Yeah.
I'm like, that's fun. That makes it an entirely different game and experience just because you're able to do that.
Like, and especially when you're playing on a controller, you press the button and you see all that happen and then you're just kind of waiting. Mm-hmm. This active motion reload makes me feel like it's on me if it happens slow. And I'm not waiting. So like I'm behind, like I'm shooting, I run out of bullets, I jump behind the wall, I crouch, I dump the clip, put it in, rack it. Now I can come back around. Yeah. It feels cool.
When you get caught on the reload in VR, you feel like you really got caught in the reload, not just caught waiting for the animation to do its thing and whatever. It's like, no, they legit caught me in the middle and I'm like dropping my clip like, oh God, oh, you know.
Oh my God. Good. So yes, big thumbs up from us over here.
Yeah.
Thanks for spending the time to hold my hand and teach me a few things today. It's always appreciated.
The student is becoming the master. That let's not forget the last kill, okay? I certainly will not forget it, okay? And we're going to play we got to play this again. We got to get more people because like with two it was that much fun and I feel like it's easy enough to get people set up on this. Like you just hand them a Quest 2 and be like, "Here you go. It's like cake. Let's go."
It's so simple. It's so simple.
Yeah.
Well, check us out here. We've got our resident VR queen, Nuke Dukem here.
Thank you.
To show us the way. So if you have any VR questions or games you should play, anything like that, make sure you tweet her. Make sure you tweet her the very important questions. Hashtag VR queen.
I'll take it. You know, it is a big passion. I've been saying for a long time, I think VR is like the future. And Oculus like took it to the next level to make it just this like all in one setup. You don't need sensors. You don't need all this stuff. It's just like right there. Take your controllers, take your headset, you're good to go. And I'm like, yes, we need this. And more people will play and more games will be made and more VR will be had for us all.
Hell yeah. Well, thank you guys for watching this episode. We appreciate it. Make sure you follow the channel on Instagram and Twitter at UpUpDownDown without the O's. Nuke Duke, and where can they find you on socials?
You can find me at Jessamyn Duke on everything. So just look it up. Just look it up and follow me and say hello and call me VR Queen. I like that.
Hashtag VR queen. All right, you can follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Austin Creed Wins. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. But most importantly, make sure you always and forever keep it tight.
All right, I'm gonna go play more.